गुड इवनिंग। हेलो, दिस इज तेनमुरी देवराज। टुडेज क्लास विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट व्हाट इज मीन बाय वाटर पोल्यूशन। वाटर पोल्यूशन अकर्स व्हेन हार्मफुल सब्सटेंसेस, ऑफन केमिकल्स और माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, कंटामिनेट अ स्ट्रीम, रिवर, लेक, ओशियन और अदर बॉडी ऑफ वाटर, degrading water quality and rendering it toxic to humans or the environment. Yes, this planet Earth is for everyone, I mean for all the living creatures and the environment. Depending on the pure water, that is fresh water, all the human beings and environment is living on this planet. Without water, nobody can live in this planet, and day by day with the unwanted activities of humans, the water is being contaminated. As you can see, we are living in the planet Earth. It is almost 3%, only 3% of fresh water is available on the planet Earth. And remaining 97% is full of seawater, which cannot be used for any purposes, especially for drinking and other daily need works. Getting into the next topic, we'll be seeing three factual information. So I'll just read out the three important and also the factual informations of water pollution. The first one is around 70% of the industrial waste is dumped into the water bodies where they pollute the usable water supply. 14 billion pounds of garbage, mostly plastic, is dumped into the ocean every year. About 700 million people worldwide drink contaminated water. Yes, with the harmful and with the unwanted activities, we people are going to suffer without water, the pure water. Each and every day, all the factories and even the human beings, every human being is directly or indirectly contaminating the water by usage of plastics and connecting the sewage and septic tanks into the ground level water, the groundwater, which will be in the surface of the ground. And all the factories and other industries are passing their waste substances and toxic water into the ocean. And there the factories and other people also polluting the ocean as well. The next topic is, what are the causes of water pollution? Water is uniquely vulnerable to pollution, known as a universal solvent. Yes, the thing is, water is also known as universal solvent. Whatever the substances you are mixing with water, the water get polluted. And that's why even the other fresh water, ground level water and ocean is also getting polluted very easily. It's also why water is easily polluted. Toxic substances from farms, towns and factories readily dissolve into and mix with it, causing water pollution. So, and water is also able to dissolve more substances than any other liquid on earth. If you just take 1 tablespoon of salt, and when you mix it with a glass of water, you can see that salt will be easily dissolvent. When you take a soil, 2 spoons or 1 spoon of soil, and mix it with water, it will be easily dissolved in the water. So this is why the water is a universal solvent liquid. And one more thing is, when you just want to talk about the oil spills and other hazardous things which is being released by the factories and other industries, it will not get mixed with the ocean and water. It will be just retained on the ocean on the top layer. Oil spills is a major cause of ocean pollution. So though the oil will not be dissolved in the water, the area which has been covered with oil spills will not be absorbed, and it cannot be taken out of the ocean as well. And moreover, all the very big companies and very big industries, if they met with any kind of accidents by spilling the oil spills on the ocean, they are not taking a very larger steps to take out that oil spills from the ocean. And the next topic is categories of water pollution, groundwater. Let me explain about this water cycle. One second. Yes, let me explain about the water cycle. So this is the water where the water will be evaporated. Evaporation in the sense when the liquid state changes its own state to gaseous state is known as evaporation. And that will be changed into the form of clouds. Okay, and condensation, it is a reverse process of evaporation, where the gaseous state will be turned into the water state, that is liquid state. Precipitation is the water which is present in the clouds will be again sent to the earth with the help of or in the form of liquid state, that is rain or snow or in some other way. Okay, again the water will be collected in the ground level. I mean, it will again just connect with the ocean and other water water bodies. This is a normal thing, and the water will be sustained in the ground level, which will be completely used for drinking purpose and other things. The normal salt water cannot be used for drinking purpose. So when I just want to talk about groundwater, when rain falls and seeps deep into the earth, filling the cracks, crevices and porous spaces of an aquifer. So basically an underground storehouse of water. So when you see the ground, you cannot able to see the water which is present beneath the sand or soil. There is some water bodies like there is a place where all the waters which is absorbed by the soil will be retained in the storehouse, in the area. So that is known as groundwater. It becomes groundwater. Yes, as I said now, one of our least visible but most important natural resources. Yes, nearly 40% of Americans rely on groundwater pumped to the earth's surface for drinking water. Yes, for some folks in rural areas, it's their only fresh water source. Groundwater gets polluted when contaminants from pesticides and fertilizers to waste leached from landfills and septic tanks. So this water ground or groundwater will be contaminated when it is mixed with pesticides and fertilizers, which is used by the farmers and the farming land. So when the pesticides is sprayed or some other chemical menus which is sown on the agricultural field, so when water is mixed with that kind of pesticides and other substances which is harmful substances, it will be again absorbed by the soil. So whatever we are giving, we'll be getting it written back. And the pesticides and fertilizers, as I said, all the things will be absorbed by the soil, and that water will also be collected in the underground, make their way into an aquifer, rendering it unsafe for human use. When the chemicals are passed into the groundwater, the groundwater is the only resource which is used for drinking purpose, right? So when these kind of harmful toxicants absorbed by the soil, and when it is mixed with the groundwater level, then the groundwater is also being contaminated, and then it makes the drinking water it will not be useful for the human, and it is harmful for the animals and the environment as well. Ridding groundwater of contaminants can be difficult to impossible, as well as costly. When we want to clean the groundwater system, and when we just want to purify the groundwater, it is more costly. Once polluted, an aquifer may be unusable for decades. Maybe it will take more years to clean it by itself, and or even thousands of years. I explained about this PPT. Next is surface water. Covering about 70% of the earth, surface water is what fills our ocean, lakes, rivers, and all those other blue bits on the world map. According to the most recent surveys on national water quality from the US Environmental Protection Agency, nearly half of the rivers and streams and more than one third of our lakes are polluted and unfit for swimming, fishing, and drinking. So as he said, once the water is contaminated, it cannot be used for swimming, fishing, and any other purposes, because as he said, once the water is polluted, it is harmful for the humans, and it is also harmful for other living creatures, where other living creatures, in a sense, fish and other small microorganisms, coral reefs, and everything which is present in the water bodies will also get spoiled, and it will also die soon. Nutrient pollution, which includes nitrates and phosphates, so this is the chemical name, is the leading type of contamination in these freshwater sources. While plants and animals need these nutrients to grow, they have become a major pollutant due to farm waste and fertilizer runoff. As I said, when they are using chemicals in one place, it is not like it is being used in only one place. Actually, it is being observed, and it is mixed along with other surface water and ground level water as well. And basically, it will spoil everything. Okay? Next, the topic, ocean water. 80% of ocean pollution is also called marine pollution. Originates on land, whether along the coast or far inland. Contaminants such as chemicals, nutrients, and heavy metals are carried from farms, factories, and cities by streams and rivers into our bays and estuaries. From there, they travel out to sea. Meanwhile, marine debris, particularly plastic, is blown in by the wind or washed in via storm drains and sewers. Our seas are also sometimes spoiled by oil spills and leaks. As I was talking about the oil spills, right? And leaks, big and small. So when any ships or any kind of very big boats or something, when it is traveled or when it is sailed on the ocean, if there is any leakage in the oil tank or something, surely that will also is one of the pollutant. So or consistently soaking up carbon pollution from the air. So here in ocean water, like all the chemicals and all the factories, as I was talking before, all the chemical factories and other factories, whatever the chemicals and other substances, which is hazardous to human health as well as the living creatures, it is illegally you know, passed into the ocean, and they do have a protocols actually, but without, you know, respecting that kind of protocols, these kind of sewage systems and other chemical pollutants and all, so it has been passed in the ocean, and there the ocean is also get polluted. And when I just want to talk about plastics, as I said in the starting, we humans also directly or indirectly making use of plastics daily, and that is also we cannot say, as we learned that there is no proper way to compose plastic. So that plastics is also sent to the ocean, either directly by the humans, as I can say, or indirectly by storms and other things. So why it is we are throwing the plastics, straws, polythene bags, and other micro kind of plastics and all on the roads, and we are not putting it in the dustbin and all. So it is completely washed with the rainwater, and again it is connected to the drainage system, and that drainage system is connected to the ocean. Point source: when contamination originates from a single source, it is called point source pollution. Examples include wastewater, also called effluent, discharged legally or illegally by a manufacturer, oil refinery, or wastewater treatment facility, as well as contamination from leaking septic tanks, septic systems, chemical and oil spills, and illegal dumping. The EPA regulates point source pollution by establishing limits on what can be discharged by a facility directly into a body of water. While pointing source pollution originates from a specific place, it can affect miles of waterways and ocean. So point source is when it is illegally or legally, when it is dumped in one place, or when it is connected to ocean or something, when one factory or oil refinery, factories or industry, something. So the ultimate thing is when one factory is doing it, surely the pollutant, the effect of pollutant will be like over miles. And with this, I just want to show you some of the images. Yes, so you can see this, all the plastics, water bottles, and all the microplastics in the sense. It will be plastic, but in the form of, in a very smaller size. So it is a very harmful and dangerous things to human, and even for the sea creatures and the environment. It will not be decomposed for over many years. So usage of plastics, see the reflection, what are all the things we done for the earth. So completely plastics, and this place, don't think that it's a very big thing and all. It is completely full of tires. Effect of oil spill. So this bird is completely got all over its body with oil spills. As I said, oil spills will not be absorbed by the water, and it will not be dissolved in the water. It will be on the above the water level. So it will cause this kind of effects. This whale, so it is completely, it ate all the plastics in the ocean. It thought that it's completely full of fishes and other food which it wants to eat, but it is completely full of plastics. It died after consuming more plastics. It's a very heart-touching pictures. See the nets and other plastics which is thrown on the ocean by the fishermen and other boats and other ships and all. So it will just stuck in their body. So according to the statistics, 90% of the living creatures which is present in the ocean is completely consumed with plastics. So with this, I'll end the slide. See, the civilized man and the uncivilized man. I can say human, uncivilized people. They are not, using any kind of plastics. They are just, it's completely crystal clear. The water is completely crystal clear. And civilized, we are consuming lot more of, plastics. We knew it's harmful. We knew it's hazardous. Even though government said that, we should not supposed to use any kind of plastics, we still use plastics in our everyday life. Some of the plastics cannot be, changed in our daily lives, but some can be changed. For example, polythene bags, usage of cloth bags or some other bags will help you to stop buying more polythene bags. If one person in this whole planet is buying only one polythene bag in a day, then think of the entire globe. In all the people will be thinking that only one carry bag, so it will be like a huge number. And usage of straws, so I didn't add any kind of videos here. So when you use a single straw, it's a single usage, right? You'll just drink the cool drink and then you'll throw it off, and that kind of straws will go and stuck in the nostrils of tortoise and turtles. And they don't know how to take out. Actually, they don't have any kind of hands and any kind of thinking mind how to get rid of it actually. So it will, at the end, it will almost die. So because of our conception, the living creatures which has not done any kind of mistakes also dying because of us. So that should be, that can be, cannot, can, that can be avoided actually. And usage of straws, like you can use paper straws instead of that. Otherwise, just tell the people that you are not supposed to sell these kind of things. Like if you take one step and every people, what they'll be thinking is, if we change, the change will happen. Of course, yes. The changes should come from ourselves, not with others. If we change, surely all the other people will also get changed. Thank you so much. We'll end the session here. Thank you.